today, Jay.
The morning of the weigh-in, everybody's making weight. Yeah. The good part about heavyweights, Deontay, Wilder does not have to kill himself until 2 p.m. That's a punishment.
Oh, yeah, he's good, man.
No, yeah, he good. He more than good, baby.
He says three rounds, Malik.
I say in five, so we agree with just a different number.
What do you say, Tay Jones?
Between 3 to 5.
What do you say, Coach?
Oh, yeah, I say the same thing. Yeah, we agree. So we, you know what I mean? We got a lot in common. We agree. That shit ain't gonna last. One now.
You've been working with him for many, many years.
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
He was benching 300. Is that all you?
Over 300.
Over 300.
I don't know who else it would be when, he was the one underneath the weight.
Right.
But as a strength and conditioning coach, you know what I mean? I had a little something to do with it, you know? I'm a bad motherfucker when it comes to this strength and condition. I'm putting everybody on notice right now.
Tell them where to follow
True Fit Athletics, all right? At True Fit Athletics on IG, baby.
And you've been around him for many years. This is the happiest he's been, most dangerous he's been?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. Well, he always been dangerous in the world. Know that. Y'all just in denial, you know what I mean?
42 wins, 41 knockouts. It doesn't happen. If it was so easy, why don't other people do it?
Exactly. Amen. See?
That's what I say. But everyone likes to, in life, to put you down until you leave, and then they love you.
Yeah, yeah. You got to close your eyes forever for people to bring you your flowers. Yeah. You know what I mean? So appreciate him now while his eyes are still open.
I agree.
So, you know, it's one of them things, man. He's reintroducing himself to the world. Since they didn't like the old Deontay, he let them into the sensitive part of his heart, you know. So, he got to reintroduce himself to, you know, another human being, and that's what he's going to do, you know, come Saturday, yep. Saturday night.
Yeah.
And I think we all are reinvented, to be honest with you. Malik is reinvented.
Malik did a great job in camp.
Oh, hell yeah.
I saw a lot of head moving, body shot, jabbing, a lot of stuff that we didn't see before. Like, he didn't need to use it.
Most definitely.
But you brought it to the front and center. Then Tay Jones had a phenomenal knockout. Did you see that?
Knockout of the year.
Good. For the body, man.
Body, set up, head. Yeah, we still looking for old boy mouthpiece.
Hell yeah.
But then, you know what, like for real though, Kun came out a better time, but at the same time, that comes from listening to Malik, listening to Dunn, and listening to Big Shot Sean Fry at the gym, like understanding what to do is different.
The mechanics, too.
He set it up so beautiful, didn't he?
Yeah.
I love him knock. Them decoy knockouts are my favorites.
Yeah.
Canelo does a lot of stuff like that, where he faints and then he goes in.
Oh, yeah.
But this is exciting. So the morning of the weigh-in, the team is just chilling. One thing I did notice about you guys, this camp, a lot of smiles, a lot of good energy, a lot of laughter. Like, it's the place you want to be. You're happy.
Yeah, absolutely. And you could be like that when you know you have the most violent, the most dynamic heavyweight that you represent. And that's where my confidence comes from. Everybody be wondering, well, Malik Scotty's talking, yeah, I hear what he's saying, but y'all not seeing what I'm seeing.
They don't know him like you guys know him.
And I'm saying this at the top level, at the top level. And keep this in mind, the program Joey has had him on has stepped his level up in this camp, and what I contributed as his head trainer, this is the scary part. We're just getting started with him. This Deontay Wilder, really, this was his first real camp. As far as this being creative, this being open-minded, being this dynamic. Can you imagine? That's why I keep saying, if he continues to stay like this, the Fury will be the least of his worries. Mm-hmm. The whole division is about to be put on notice again. And that's saying a lot, being the fact he about to be a two-time heavyweight champion with 10 title defenses, coming back to get it in blood tomorrow.
That's true. They always say Fury hasn't done one title defense.
Mm. It don't match. It don't match. You know, so... You know what, we've always had this type of energy within our camp. It's just a simple fact that the world really didn't embrace it because he was too busy trying to please the world and stop every fan, give autographs. And this is the first time that we had the opportunity to just enjoy one another and appreciate our brotherhood, because whether it's a win through all the through the loss, you just can't lose in the ring, you know. It's things that happen outside the ring that people got to understand. And for us to still be here and still be together and still have this positive energy, you know, Deontay's right. You know, this, you know, I love all my brothers that surround me. He loved all his brothers, Malik, Tay, Chris Bates. You know, all of us, we're here for a reason, for each other. And this is our first time that the world is actually seeing us interact and seeing our brotherhood, because we also putting the world on notice. This is the way that you, your team is supposed to be, through love, you know, through positivity. And that's, and that's why we're going to take that W, and he's going to be two-time in due time.
But it's crazy because they say boxing is an individual sport, but it's not, because you need a team. You need, you can't do it. You need to tank of yourself water
in the corner. And then you got to realize this team right here, see, it come across because you guys only see us when you guys see us. But it's times that I'm getting on Snake nerve, and he's saying, Malik, get the fuck out of my face, I'm going to sleep. It's times me and Tay having our issues. Deontay is yelling at Bates. Deontay and Snake, we have to get in between them at times. That's like, but at the end of the day, that's what family is about. Disagreeing, agreeing to disagree, disagreeing, and getting past that shit, past problems. We faced, in my opinion, almost every emotion in this training camp. It was some fighting, it was some disagreement, but none of that ever deteriorated Deontay from staying dedicated to the craft. It never was like it was so bad that he didn't show up to the gym, or it was so bad he didn't want to train, or it was so bad. And you gotta realize, Joey was getting him up at every day at 6:30 in the morning. Everyone in the world knows Deontay Wilder is not a real morning person. Joey specifically made him go into an uncomfortable zone with that. You even get that? Like, you know what I'm saying, Ellie?
He's knowing. A lot of fighters are not morning persons. That's what I'm trying to say. Nobody likes to do strength and conditioning. Everybody likes to spar.
A lot of fighters are not morning people, right?
Yeah.
So their team has to fire.
Correct. Has to wake him up. Has to get him out of bed.
He didn't give
job.
A fuck about that.
Yeah, I didn't give
you're
a fuck.
You're with the bad guy.
Man, we getting the work done. If it takes me being a bad guy, yeah, for him to display his greatness across the world, uh-huh, then that's what we're doing. Like, that's what we're willing to do.
Manny Pacquiao was up all night with Congress, see? Right. He had a couple hours of sleep, and his team were very hesitant to wake him up. Justin Fortune, the strength and vision coach,
I'm
Manny,
at the door.
Let's go.
Literally, I'm at the door. I stayed with him. Literally.
And it paid off, because look at him now. He's in a good place physically, mentally. He's good to go.
Most definitely.
I can't wait.
Most definitely. A lot of people is wondering, you know, is the weight going to be a difference? Not when you got a bad motherfucker like me coaching you. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So I believe in, you know, functional training. He wasn't just in there bench pressing. He wasn't just in there doing curls to get big. No, we were doing functional training, and he was able to. Everything works as one. From the technical aspect with Malik, from my strength and conditioning, from the nutrition with Jacqueline, from Dr. Elamine, you know, making sure that his body is rejuvenated.
Jay strategizing.
Jake.